The supercontinent Pangea is one of the most fascinating and important geological events in Earth's history. Pangea, which means all lands in Greek, was a supercontinent that formed around 300 million years ago and existed until around 200 million years ago. During this time, all of the continents on Earth were fused together into a single landmass with a single ocean surrounding it. Before we go any further, make sure that you are subscribed to our channel. Creation theory. Proto-Laurasia, a minor supercontinent, drifted away from Gondwana and moved across the Panthalassic Ocean before Pangaea formed. The Proto-Tethys Ocean was forming between the two continents. Proto-Laurasia soon split into Laurentia, Siberia as a continent, and Baltica. The rifting also resulted in the formation of two new oceans, the Iamphitis and Tanti Oceans. Baltica remained to the east of Laurentia, while Siberia was to the northeast. The independent continent of Laurentia, on what would become North America, sat on the equator in the Cambrian, surrounded by three oceans, the Panthalassic Ocean to the north and west, the Iapetus Ocean to the south, and the Canti Ocean to the east. The microcontinent of Avalonia, which would become the northeastern United States, Nova Scotia, and England, broke free from Gondwana and began its journey to Laurentia in the earliest Ordovician. By the end of the Ordovician, Baltica had collided with Laurentia, and northern Avalonia had collided with Baltica and Laurentia. Laurentia, Baltica, and Avalonia merged to form a minor Euro-American supercontinent known as Laurentia, closing the Iapetus Ocean while the Right Ocean expanded along Avalonia's southern coast. The northern Appalachians were also formed as a result of the collision. Siberia was close to Europe, with the Canti Ocean separating the two. While all of this was going on, Gondwana was slowly drifting towards the South Pole. This was the first step in Pangaea's formation. The collision of Gondwana and Euramerica was the second step in the formation of Pangaea. Baltica had already collided with Laurentia to form Euramerica by the Silurian period. Avalonia and Laurentia had not yet collided, and the seaway between them, a remnant of the Iapetus Ocean, was still shrinking as Avalonia inched closer to Laurentia. Meanwhile, southern Europe split from Gondwana and began to migrate towards Euramerica across the newly formed Reich Ocean, colliding with southern Baltica in the Devonian. This microcontinent, however, was an underwater plate. Canti Ocean, Iapetus Ocean's sister ocean, was also contracting as an island arc from Siberia collided with eastern Baltica, now part of Euramerica. A new ocean, the Ural Ocean, lay behind this island arc. North China continent and South China continent rifted away from Gondwana and began to head northward across the shrinking Proto-Tethys Ocean, with the new Paleo-Tethys Ocean opening on its southern end. During the Devonian period, Gondwana moved towards Euramerica, causing the Reich Ocean to contract. In the early Carboniferous, Northwest Africa collided with the southeastern coast of Europe, forming the southern Appalachian Mountains and the Meseta Mountains. South America moved north to southern Europe, while the eastern part of Gondwana, India, Antarctica, and Australia moved south to the South Pole. North and South China were on separate continents. The microcontinent of Kazakhstania had collided with Siberia. Since the deformation of the supercontinent Pannotia in the Middle Carboniferous, the Siberian continent has existed as a separate continent for millions of years. In the late Carboniferous, Western Kazakhstania collided with Baltica, closing the Ural Ocean between them and resulting in the formation of the Ural Mountains and the Laurasia supercontinent. This was the final stage of Pangaea's formation. Meanwhile, South America and Southern Laurentia collided, closing the Reich Ocean and forming the southernmost Appalachians and Ouacha Mountains. Gondwana had reached the South Pole by this time, and glaciers were forming in Antarctica, India, Australia, Southern Africa, and South America. By the late Carboniferous period, the North China Bloc had collided with Siberia, effectively closing the Proto-Tethys Ocean. By the early Permian, the Sumerian Plate had rifted away from Gondwana and was heading towards Laurasia, forming the new Tethys Ocean on its southern end and closing the Paleo-Tethys Ocean. The majority of the landmasses were combined into one. Pangaea had rotated slightly to the southwest by the Triassic period. Until the Middle Jurassic, the Sumerian Plate was still moving across the shrinking Paleo-Tethys. The Sumerian orogeny was formed when Paleo-Tethys closed from west to east. Pangea resembled a letter C with an ocean inside it, the new Tethys Ocean. However, Pangea rifted by the Middle Jurassic. Biodiversity and climate. Regardless of the exact mechanism, the formation of Pangea had a profound impact on the Earth's climate, vegetation, and animal life. The supercontinent was home to a wide variety of plants and animals, many of which were adapted to the unique conditions found on Pangea. Some of the most iconic animals of the time, such as dinosaurs and pterosaurs, lived and evolved on Pangea. One of the most significant effects of the formation of Pangea was the creation of a land bridge between the two major continents of Gondwana and Laurasia. This land bridge allowed for the exchange of plants and animals between the two continents, leading to an increase in biodiversity. For example, it is thought that the dinosaurs and pterosaurs that lived on Pangea were able to migrate and spread across the supercontinent due to the presence of this land bridge. It is thought that the breakup of Pangea may have played a role in the evolution of the dinosaurs, as they were adapted to the warm, humid climate found on the supercontinent. The cooler, drier climate that followed the breakup of Pangea may have contributed to the extinction of the dinosaurs. The formation of Pangea also had a major impact on the Earth's climate. The supercontinent was much larger than any of the continents we know today, and it was surrounded by a single vast ocean. This would have caused the climate to be much more uniform across the entire supercontinent, with similar weather patterns and temperatures found from one end of Pangea to the other. In addition to the impact on climate and vegetation, the breakup of Pangea had a major effect on the evolution of human beings. It is thought that the first humans evolved in Africa, and that they were able to migrate to other parts of the world as the continents broke apart and became more isolated. The separation of the continents allowed for the evolution of different human populations, each adapted to the unique conditions found on their respective continents. In contrast, the breakup of Pangea led to the formation of the modern continents, each with their own unique climates and ecosystems. The separation of the continents allowed for the evolution of a wide variety of plant and animal life, as species were able to adapt to the different conditions found on each continent. As the continents moved apart, the Earth's climate cooled, leading to the formation of polar ice caps and the development of the modern climate zones. Division of Pangea. Pangea began to break up about 200 million years ago in the same way that it was formed, through tectonic plate movement caused by mantle convection. Just as Pangea was formed through the movement of new material away from rift zones, new material also caused the supercontinent to separate. Scientists believe that the rift that would ultimately divide Pangea began due to a point of weakness in the Earth's crust. At that weak area, magma surfaced and created a volcanic rift zone. Eventually, this rift zone grew so large that it formed a basin and Pangea started to dissociate. Ocean formation. Distinct oceans were formed as Panthalassa occupied newly opened areas of the landmass. The first ocean to form was the Atlantic. About 180 million years ago, a portion of the Atlantic Ocean opened up between North America and northwestern Africa. Around 140 million years ago, the South Atlantic Ocean formed when today's South America separated from the west coast of southern Africa. The Indian Ocean emerged when India separated from Antarctica and Australia. About 80 million years ago, North America and Europe, Australia and Antarctica, and India and Madagascar followed suit and separated. Over millions more years, the continents moved to their approximate current positions. Evidence for Pangea. Not everyone is convinced that Pangea ever existed, but there is plenty of evidence that experts use to prove that it did. The strongest support has to do with how the continents fit together. Other evidence for Pangea includes fossil distribution, distinctive patterns in rock strata spread out all around the world, and the global placement of coal. Continents fitting together. As Alfred Wegener, creator of the continental drift theory, noticed in the early 20th century, the Earth's continents seem to fit together like a jigsaw puzzle. This is the most significant evidence for Pangea's existence. The most prominent place where this is visible is along the northwestern coast of Africa and the eastern coast of South America. In these locations, the two continents look like they could have been connected at one point, and many believe that they were in the time of Pangea. Fossil distribution. Archaeologists have found matching fossil remains of ancient terrestrial and freshwater species in continents now separated by thousands of miles of ocean. For example, matching freshwater reptile fossils have been found in Africa and South America. Because crossing the Atlantic Ocean would have been impossible for these saltwater-averse creatures, Their fossils indicate that the two continents must have once been connected. Rock patterns. Patterns in rock strata are another indicator of the existence of Pangea. Geologists have discovered distinctive patterns in rocks on continents nowhere near each other. Coastal configurations were the first marker to point to a jigsaw puzzle-like continent layout years ago. Then geologists were further convinced of Pangea's existence when they discovered that even rock layers on the continents that appear to have once fit together match each other exactly. This indicates that continents must have grown apart, as identical rock stratification couldn't have been a coincidence. Coal placement. Finally, the world's coal distribution is evidence for Pangea in much the same way that fossil distribution is. Coal normally forms in warm, wet climates. However, scientists have found coal under Antarctica's frigid, dry ice caps. For this to be possible, it is believed that the icy continent was previously in another location on the Earth and had a very different climate, which had to have been supportive of coal formation from today. In conclusion, Pangea was a major event in Earth's history, one that had a significant impact on the planet's climate, vegetation, and animal life. Its formation and breakup had far-reaching consequences, shaping the world we know today and influencing the evolution of life on Earth. The legacy of Pangea can still be seen in the way that the continents fit together and in the diversity of plants and animals that inhabit the planet. If you enjoyed today's video, then feel free to smash the like button and subscribe to our channel.